Hello everyone, my name is Stijn Schildermans. I am a PhD student from KU Leuven in Belgium, and it is my honor to present to you Paratic, which is a method to reduce timer overhead in virtual machines. First, let's start with some background information. As you all probably know, timekeeping is a fundamental duty of the operating system. Here you can see how this process works in Linux, but most operating systems follow a similar approach. The kernel programs a periodic hardware timer interrupt at a fixed frequency, usually between 100 and 1000 Hz, which is called the scheduler tick. Whenever a tick interrupt arrives, the kernel performs some bookkeeping work, such as scheduling and accounting, which is here represented by the doTick function, and updates a global variable representing the system time, which is called jiffies in Linux. What is very interesting about this approach is that when an application asks the kernel to program a timer, the physical timer hardware is actually not touched in the majority of cases. Instead, the kernel creates something called a soft timer interrupt, which is no more than an entry in a dedicated array-like data structure, which is called the timer wheel in Linux. Upon every context switch, the timer wheel is checked for expired soft interrupts. Obviously, the recurring scheduler tick interrupts that we just discussed ensure that such a context switch takes place at least every tick period. This means that almost the entire timekeeping subsystem is backed by the scheduler tick, knowing that many of the other kernel subsystems, of course, and applications as well, rely on the timekeeping in one way or another. This makes the scheduler tick perhaps one of the most critical operating system components. Historically, all operating systems used a simple periodic scheduler tick recurring at a fixed interval, like the tick we discussed a second ago. In modern systems, this is, however, problematic because the tick has to be programmed on every CPU in the system. Because modern systems often contain many cores, most of which are idle most of the time, lots of resources are being wasted on processing scheduler ticks that have no real purpose, because idle CPUs obviously cannot perform any useful work anyway. To address this problem, the concept of tickless kernels was introduced several years ago, first in Linux, but by now it has been adopted by most mainstream operating systems. As you can see on the left here, the tick interrupts themselves are largely handled analogously to periodic ticks. Additionally, however, the scheduler tick is disabled whenever a CPU enters the idle loop, unless some system component explicitly asks for it to be retained. If there are any scheduled soft interrupts or RCU events, the tick is not disabled entirely, but deferred until the expiry time of the first of those events. Of course, if the tick was disabled upon idle entry, it has to be re-enabled upon idle exit, as you can see on the right here. As I said in the beginning of this presentation, this work is about optimizing timers in virtual machines. So let's take a look how this timer mechanism behaves when we virtualize it. Let's start with classic periodic ticks. The problem here is that every time a tick interrupt arrives, the timer hardware has to be reprogrammed. In a virtual machine, this is a problem because guest kernels cannot be allowed to directly manipulate the hardware, as this may interfere with other virtual machines on the system. Therefore, whenever a guest attempts to reprogram the timer hardware, the CPU triggers what is called a VM exit and passes control to a separate piece of software, which is called a hypervisor. This hypervisor can be described as a kind of kernel for virtualized environments and is responsible for coordinating hardware resources between virtual machines and enforcing isolation between those virtual machines. In the case of a guest attempting to alter the timer hardware, as we have here on the left, the hypervisor will simply program its own timer, which is identical to the one the virtual machine just attempted to program, and then returns control back to the virtual machine through a so-called VM entry. When this hypervisor level timer expires, the CPU will again trigger a VM exit and pass control to the hypervisor. And the hypervisor will then simply inject a virtual tick interrupt into the virtual machine. All of this means that every few milliseconds, every CPU will suffer a pair of VM exits, even if the VM is entirely idle, especially in heavily overcommitted systems where multiple vCPUs are sharing the same physical CPU. This can be problematic because, of course, each of those vCPUs must receive its own scheduler tick. So this can lead to excessive virtualization overhead because the hypervisor needs to inject thousands and thousands of virtual scheduler ticks every second. Tickless kernels luckily perform a lot better in such overcommitted virtualized scenarios because, again, they do not require scheduler ticks to be injected into idle vCPUs. However, these tickless kernels have another big problem, namely the tick has to be reprogrammed upon almost every transition between active and idle vCPU states. Some workloads, unfortunately, by design, cause many of these transitions. For example, multi-threaded applications relying on blocking synchronization and I/O intensive applications. And for such workloads, tickless kernels may in fact induce more tick-related virtualization overhead than classic periodic ticks because of all those transitions between active and idle states. From all of this, it is clear that none of the existing tick management methods work really well in a virtualized environment. To address this, we came up with an alternative tick management concept, which we call virtual scheduler ticks. We implemented this concept in Linux KVM under the name Paratick. The source code is freely available on GitHub. The basic principle behind virtual scheduler ticks is actually very simple. Namely, we assert that timer hardware should only be managed by software which is in full control of the system. In bare metal environments, this is of course already the case because the kernel is responsible for this. In a virtualized environment, however, the kernel is no longer in full control of the timer hardware, but still attempts to manage it. And this forces the hypervisor to intervene, as we saw a few slides ago. And this is what causes all of this excessive virtualization overhead. Therefore, we propose to cut the guest kernel entirely from this equation and allow only the hypervisor to manage the scheduler ticks for all virtual machines. This can be achieved through paravirtualization. We propose that VMs, when they boot up, simply request from the hypervisor to inject virtual scheduler ticks at a certain frequency, and the hypervisor will then be responsible for managing the physical timer hardware in such a way that the guest will get interrupted at the appropriate times. At the host side, the algorithm we came up with to implement this concept, which is Paratick, is quite simple actually. On each VM exit, we check if the time elapsed since the last tick injection is larger than the tick period requested by the virtual machine. If so, we inject a virtual scheduler tick. At the guest side, the handler for this virtual tick simply performs any needed bookkeeping and returns. There is one issue with the simplistic approach, however. Namely, when a vCPU enters idle, it is descheduled by the hypervisor and it will thus not receive any more virtual scheduler ticks. However, it may still have scheduled some RCU events or soft interrupts that expire at some point in the future. If we do not take these events into account, the vCPU will never wake up and never be able to service these events because the guest is completely dependent on the host to inject virtual scheduler ticks, which will never happen if the vCPU is not scheduled. Eventually, this would stall the entire system. Therefore, upon each idle entry, the guest must check for any scheduled events and, if necessary, program a dedicated physical timer to force the hypervisor to inject a virtual tick when these events expire. The handler for this physical timer is mostly identical to that for virtual scheduler ticks, as you can see on the right of the slide here. We evaluated Paratick relative to a regular tickless Linux kernel hosted on a KVM hypervisor for a variety of workloads. Specifically, we evaluated VM exits, system throughput, and application execution time for sequential, multi-threaded, and IO-heavy workloads. As you can see, Paratick drastically reduces VM exits for all of these. For sequential workloads, system throughput and application execution time are only modestly improved, however. This is likely caused by the fact that virtualization overhead is very low for such workloads to begin with, so even a large reduction in virtualization overhead only has a small impact on overall performance. Multi-threaded applications, on the other hand, benefit much more in terms of throughput, but still do not show much improvement of execution times. This is a little bit counterintuitive, but most likely this can be explained by the fact that most VM exits that we eliminate using Paratick are actually not located on the critical path of the application and therefore have no impact on execution time. IO-heavy workloads, finally, do benefit greatly both in terms of throughput and execution time. In conclusion, when it comes to timekeeping in virtual machines, both traditional tick management techniques induce problematic overhead for certain workloads. We proposed paravirtualizing the scheduler tick in order to mitigate these issues, and we have shown that our proof of concept implementation of virtual scheduler ticks, which we named Paratick, drastically reduces VM exits and increases system throughput, in some cases also significantly reducing application execution time. Thus, virtual scheduler ticks is, in our estimation, a promising concept which we hope will one day find its way into the mainline Linux kernel. Thank you for your attention.